Did you know that learning a language is a natural process? Yes, even if you're an adult, you have natural language learning abilities, and with your choices, you can choose to help or hinder those abilities. In this video, I will share 9 powerful ways that you can boost these French learning abilities that we all have. If that sounds interesting, keep watching. My name is Angèle Préteau, and on this channel, we talk about what it really takes to learn French. Make sure you subscribe because I make videos every single Monday and you don't want to miss them. Many people believe that children can just learn languages naturally and adults just can't, or maybe they can, but it's a lot harder for them. This is just not true. And here is where this misconception comes from. Toddlers learn the language around them naturally and we retain these abilities as adults as well. But what changes is our environment. When you learn French as an adult, you are never as entirely surrounded by the language as French toddlers are. I mean, think of it, they soak in it 24/7. It follows that learning French as an adult will require a little bit more intentionality than that of a toddler. The good news is you have it. I mean, toddlers are not very intentional most of the time. As an adult, you can set out to consciously learn French, and that is a powerful asset. So let's look at these 9 ways to boost your brain's natural French learning abilities. All these ways are super easy, yet very powerful. All you have to do is implement a few of those tweaks in your life and watch your French skyrocket. And actually, you might already be doing some of these things. If that's the case, please let me know in the comment below. I look forward to reading it. Number one is the daily French bath. If you've been following this channel for a little while, you've heard of it, you know what that is. And if you haven't, the daily French bath just consists in listening to some French content every day. You want to surround yourself with the French language as much as possible. All of my students are strongly encouraged. I mean, I wish I could force them, but I really can't. So I strongly encourage them and you to do it just because of how powerful it is. I've made an entire video about this. So I will put the link up here and you can watch it next. Number 2 is repetition. Tony Robbins likes to say that repetition is the mother of skill. This is due to an interesting brain feature known as the mere exposure effect. It's actually a cognitive bias, and basically our brain thinks that something is important just because we see it or hear it often. And because what we see or hear often feels important to us, we also tend to remember it. So you can harness this brain feature by selecting important words and phrases and looking at them regularly. 5 minutes every day really goes a long way. This is also the topic of one of my previous videos, which I link up here, about how you can learn vocabulary with just 5 minutes a day. Number 3 is to use images and text in your environment. Would you like an even simpler way to harness the mere exposure effect? A way that involves no effort at all, not even reviewing a notebook? You got it. There is this thing called peripheral perception, and it's basically a handy way to trick your brain into learning French. If there's something you just can't remember, like say a difficult word or the conjugation of a difficult verb, then you can write it on a paper and stick it to a place where you can see it often. Some of my favorite places include the bathroom mirror, the fridge door, next to your workplace or next to your bed. And then, well, that's it. It's a complete set it and forget it solution. Well, you don't really forget it, right? You see it, but you don't have to make any additional effort. You put the thing up there once, and then you just wait until your brain works its magic. Once you notice that you can remember the word or the phrase easily without looking at the paper, then you can remove it and put another one. I will put one caveat to this technique, is that there is a limit to how much you can learn at the same time with this technique, or with any technique, by the way. I mean, your brain can only learn little by little, right? So you don't want to saturate your environment with French words, as this can overwhelm your brain and it can cause it to just ignore the information. It's also better to write in big letters so you can see it from afar. This technique works because your brain picks up on what's written without seeing it consciously. So you don't need to be aware of it, but you still need to be physically able to read it. So make it easy on your brain and give it some big, easy to read letters. I recommend you start this with just 1 or 2 words, like the conjugation of one verb, for example. Tip number 4 is enjoyable experiences. Here's the thing. Our brain is hardwired to seek pleasure and avoid pain. So if your goal is to learn French, you better have it associated with pleasure because that will make it so much easier to learn. So this is your official permission, if you need any, to indulge in everything French related that you might enjoy, whether it's food, movies, traveling to great locations, attractive French speakers, you pick. It has to be enjoyable for you, so it's all your personal idea of what's enjoyable. if you don't know where to start with that, YouTube is a great way to be in touch with French content that you enjoy and to learn while having a good time. Tip number five has to do with your friends and loved ones. Your friends and loved ones who can speak French or who also learn French and can share enjoyable experiences with you can really be a very powerful asset to your French learning because they bring another key element, which is social norm and possibly accountability. If you are in an environment where speaking French or learning French is a norm, even just some of the time, then it's very likely that we will learn to speak French too. That's because our brains are also hardwired to fit within social norms. So if the norm is to speak French, you're very likely to speak French. But conversely, if no one speaks French in your environment, it will be a lot harder to learn to speak French because of that same thing. French toddlers learn French because everyone speaks French around them, obviously. And by the way, that's how I learn French myself. Similarly, adult learners with the best success rate are immigrants who live in a French-speaking country and need to speak French in order to participate in the social life. So go to work, have any activity, and so on and so forth. Now, how can you use this feature if you're not a toddler or an immigrant and you don't live in a French-speaking country? If you have French-speaking friends or relatives, you can create a French-only day or half day or hours when you won't be allowed to speak English. You can try to do this at least once a week, and you can schedule it in advance and have your friend or relative hold you accountable. You'll be amazed at what you can say in French when you are committed and you have a supportive conversation partner. Feel free to also have a delicious meal at the time so you can leverage the enjoyable experience. Another way to harness this feature is to be part of a group of committed learners. If learning French and making progress is the norm in one of your social groups, even if it's online, then it's very likely that you will learn and make progress too. Because, like I said, this is just how we are wired. On the contrary, if the people around you think that you're weird for learning French, your chances of success decrease dramatically. So it's very important to surround yourself with supportive people at least some of the time. And if you are serious about learning French, I can only recommend that you join my group program, the French Fluency Accelerator, because the members of this group are just amazing. Even though we use the best methods in this program, several students have already said in their testimonials that their favorite part is not the methods we use or the workshops that we have, but actually the group dynamics and how lovely and supportive everyone is and how much they progress together. So you can see that a great group really makes a huge difference. And if you'd like to check it out, I encourage you to see the link in the description. Tip number six is to keep your brain fresh and working at its best. So obviously, if you're mentally exhausted, if you're sleep deprived, or if your diet doesn't nourish you appropriately, you just won't be able to get the best results in your French study. So make sure that you sleep enough, stay hydrated, eat well, etc. I have an entire video about this topic, which you can watch next. Tip number seven is to take advantage of your most productive time. As you probably know, some people work better in the morning, some people work better in the evening. It's important to know when you are at your best so that you can harness this time for studying. If you know you're exhausted after work, then don't plan a study session then because it won't work, right? Instead, go to bed earlier and get up earlier so you can study French in the morning when you're rested. You'll get much better results this way. Conversely, if you're a night owl and you can never think straight when you get up, well, then it's good to schedule your study time in the evening. Tip number eight is to create habits. So using and harnessing habits is another favorite thing of self-development fans like me, because, well, habits can be really challenging to set and put in place or change. But once you have them, it's like being able to do something on autopilot. You have no willpower required and very little attention needed. So it's a pretty good deal, in my opinion. You do the work once and then it runs smoothly and you keep getting the results. I have made this video about the two French learning habits that you need. You can check it out next. Before we get to the last tip, which is certainly the most powerful, if you have learned something in this video already, please click the like buttons and let me know in the comments what things will you try next. I look forward to reading your comments and maybe I can also give you a pointer or two. Which gets me to my last tip, which is the most powerful of all. Tip number nine is to get a coach. I once heard this amazing definition of a coach. A coach is a vehicle. If you know where you're going, your coach will get you much faster than you'd have been on your own. Your coach is here to understand your personality and your goals and to help you learn in a way that is a natural fit. And it really works. I have many students who have been learning French for years without making a lot of progress. But then when they started working with me, either one-on-one or in my group program, they suddenly started making a lot of visible progress virtually overnight. You don't have to take my word for it. I have many testimonials where they say it themselves. Getting a coach is probably the best thing you can do for your French skills because it will give you guidance and direction and all the rest will just flow and fall into place easily. So if you're ready to make a lot of progress this year, You will find the links to my programs below, and you can even book a free call to discuss the options directly with me. Before we do that, let me recap quickly our 9 elements for today's video. The first one is the daily French bath, because the more French you hear daily, the more you learn. The second tip was repetition, because if we see something and we hear something often, our brain considers it more important and learns it more easily. Tip number 3 is to use images or text in your environment to harness what we call the peripheral perception. Basically, it's some more repetition, but visual and with absolutely no effort required. Tip number 4 is enjoyable experience, because our brain is hardwired to seek pleasure and reject pain. So you can use this to your advantage by associating your French study to something enjoyable. Tip number 5 is to enlist your friends or your loved ones, because this increases your emotional connection to the language and it makes peer pressures work for you. Tip number 6 is to keep your brain fresh and working at its best. Tip number 7 is to take advantage of your most productive time, whether it's in the morning or in the evening. Tip number 8 is to create habits, because once you have them, they keep working for you on autopilot. And finally, tip number 9 is to get a coach, because a coach will help you make great use of everything on this list and so much more. So on this note, if you're ready to jump in and make faster progress, this is your reminder that you can study with me one-on-one or join my group program, the French Fluency Accelerator, and you'll find the link in the description below. Else, you can watch this other video, and I will be back next Monday with a brand new one. See you next week.